In the Sea of Japan, there's a small island whose name is Okushiri. And the southern tip of this island is a small village by the name of Ionai. All of these homes were present before July 12, 1993. And one can look at the monument that stands up in the center of your screen as a marker. 10 o'clock at night on July 12th, a magnitude 7.6 earthquake occurred that produced 1 hour of tsunami attacks, followed by intense fires. These pictures were taken moments after the tsunami had destroyed most of the village, and the fires that are raging are the effects of such a tsunami disaster. Oftentimes, people do not consider that tsunamis, which basically flood the coastline, can also start fires. But in fact, for this particular event, the fire did the most damage to the community of Ionai. Now we're looking at the breakwater that was supposed to protect this village. It has been breached by the weight of the tsunami during the 1 hour of attacks that occurred the evening before. Examine all of the debris in the water, and those are the remnants of the homes that we saw prior to this tsunami in July of 1993. We're now looking at the waterfront area, which the weight of the water crushed many of the homes and many of the buildings that were along the waterfront. But in addition to the weight of the water by the tsunami, floating debris, such as large fishing vessels, also crashed into these buildings. And as a result of this weight of the water plus the debris in the water, it had the effect of demolishing everything in its path. And this overflight on the southern tip of Okushiri Island shows a devastating effect of these waves. Notice all of the brown debris in the water are the remnants of the 500 homes that were on this tip. And now, there's only a sheet of sand with scattering of fishing boats that tell us what happened here. There's a monument we saw earlier. How could such a disaster occur? What are the processes at Earth that could create such a disaster? The Earth could be considered a large hot ball of molten lava. And on top of this large hot ball are plates that are cooled. These plates, as they rub against one another and as they dive beneath each other, build up stress during this motion. And this stress is eventually relieved through the form of an earthquake. If we look at the plates as they exist today on the surface of the planet, we see that in the Sea of Japan, there is the intersection of three of these plates. And it just so happens that one plate, the Asian plate, is diving under the North Pacific plate, precisely where Okushiri Island exists. So we could visualize then this process of a plate diving underneath another plate, building up stress, and as it relieves that stress through a rebounding process, it would lift up the water overlying and produce a tsunami, as this animation depicts. That's the genesis of a tsunami, born of fire. The map you're looking at shows the areas where the largest earthquake occurred, as indicated by the red circle, and a series of aftershock earthquakes that are indicated by the small white circles. The combination of this area, which is highlighted by light blue, is an indication of the area that was actually uplifted during this particular tsunami-causing earthquake. So we have an idea of the spatial dimensions of the formation of this tsunami. As you can see from this animation, once the tsunami is formed in the Sea of Japan, it propagates very quickly to the island of Okushiri. This wave will continue to wrap around the north and south parts of the island. At the same time, it's hitting the other island of Hokkaido, and notice as it as the two waves wrap around the backside of the island, they combine to reinforce each other and cause wave heights to be unusually large at an unexpected location on the backside of the island. This is not uncommon because tsunami waves wrap around objects and intersect the island coastline in a wide variety of ways. But the most important aspect of this is the damage it causes once it gets near the coastline. This animation of run-up depicts the overtopping of the southern tip of Ionai, and then notice how the waves in this animation depict the flooding that takes place along the coast. So now, if we look at the entire process from earthquake generation, shaking this island for about 30 seconds, followed by an attack of 3 to 4 tsunamis lasting for about an hour that gave rise to fires which burned all night, then we see that the origins of the earthquake is basically within the bowels of the earth and causes massive destruction and kills people. Now that you understand how tsunamis are formed and the potential destruction that they can bring, I'd like to share with you a few safety tips of how you can protect yourself in the event of this natural disaster. Safety tip number one is the earthquake itself. If you feel a shaking of the earth while you're on the coastline, this is nature's warning that a tsunami could have been generated. So you're advised to seek higher ground as quickly as possible. Safety tip number two is unusual water level changes. Oftentimes, tsunamis will, as they're approaching the coastline, the first indication of a tsunami's arrival will be the withdrawal of water. That is a draining away of the ocean away from the coastline. If you see large areas of the coastline exposed by this draining of the water, that is a natural warning that a tsunami is arriving. So as quickly as it drained away, it will come back with an enormous force and a very fast speed, which you cannot outrun. So you're advised, if you observe this change in sea level, to seek higher ground as quickly as possible. Safety tip number three is the sound of a tsunami. Accounts of massive tsunamis which have created death and destruction here in the last few decades are always accompanied by a loud roar. So if the tsunami occurs in the evening, it's dark, you cannot see the ocean, you cannot see the draining of the ocean, then if you hear a loud roar from the ocean, that too is nature's indication that a tsunami is approaching. So the three tips are, you feel an earthquake, if you see unusual wave sea level changes on the coastline, or if you hear a loud roar from the ocean, that's natural signal that a tsunami is approaching. If you heed these signs, you can save your life by quickly running to higher ground.